Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Mandy, the Handmade Homeschooler, and welcome to my channel. If it's your first time here, welcome. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. And if you're returning, make sure you hit the like button because it really helps me out. So today we're going to be talking about new curriculum versus used curriculum, and I have pros and cons of both. And I have done both. I have bought new and I have bought used, and I have compiled a list of pros and cons for both of them for you so you can make the best informed decision for you and your family. So I'm going to go over used first, and I want to say I've probably bought used more so than new. So I feel like I'm very used to buying used curriculum. And in the description below, I will actually pop in some of the places where I buy used curriculum so you guys can get kind of a good idea of where you should be searching for these things. So as far as the pros, of course, number one is the price. It is so much cheaper to buy used curriculum than new curriculum sometimes. However, I will say there, wait for the cons on this one. Now, number two, you might find items that are out of stock that you're wanting. So I'm sorry if I keep looking down, guys, but I want to make sure that I get all of these points for you because I feel like these are really important things. So I feel like a lot of times things can go out of stock when we need them new. Like we need that one book or we need that one piece to complete the curriculum that we want. And sometimes they just go out of stock. If it's like really popular and maybe they only have an ebook available and you don't want to do an ebook, sometimes you can actually find older editions that you might want or out of stock items when you're looking for used curriculum. Now, the cons list. Here are the cons. Okay, so a lot of times when I buy used curriculum, this is my biggest pet peeve, is people will lie about the conditions of the items when they're selling them. They will use tricks like either omitting information or not photographing the pictures of the pieces that are actually damaged or not telling you that they're missing pieces to part of the curriculum. And then you get it in the mail and all of a sudden you're like, wait a minute. This is not what I ordered. This is not what I bought. And you feel kind of cheated. That's happened to me probably at least 50% of the time. And it's really irritating because I feel like I have to go hunt down something else to fix that situation. Now, that happened to me last year when I bought a history book, and I paid $20, I think, for a history book, and the answers were written all inside of the textbook. And I was told that this book was in perfect condition. There were highlights in it. All the answers were written in, and the actual book itself, the cover and the pages, were in really bad shape. And that happened to me the last time that I bought a history book, not the master book stuff. This is a different company. And the book itself was falling apart when I got it. They actually took an image probably from somebody else's listing and used it as their own, lied about the condition of it, and I was out $20. And it was the only one left that I could find. So I was pretty mad. That happens a lot of the time, and I have seen it happen to others. I know I'm not the only person that this has happened to. However, it's really irritating when it happens. So number two, many times you'll have to buy your curriculum in pieces if you want to complete your set. I have seen a lot of people, they will sell parts of the curriculum because they just want to sell everything really fast. And you know, one person will claim this book and one person will claim this book, and then you're left with holes everywhere. Your curriculum looks like Swiss cheese. So that's kind of irritating where you have to like hunt down and track down the right books for the curriculum. So sometimes you'll have to end up buying a lot of different pieces. And I have found if I am not vigilant about it, I could actually end up paying more that way than if I had just bought the entire thing at once new. And then I feel really silly because when you add up all the shipping for all of those items, and it can get out of control really fast. Okay, number three, the additions may not be current and your teacher's manual might not line up as far as the pages and the worksheets. Because here's the thing, you can buy your textbooks used. You can buy your textbooks used, but a lot of times you're gonna have to buy the workbooks or the student sheets brand new. You can't buy those used. You can't buy used worksheets 99% of the time. Every now and then I see a parent who will actually copy off the worksheets for their kid and then sell the unused set with the curriculum packs. But a lot of times that's actually against, you know, like the copyright laws of that curriculum. And one, they shouldn't be doing that. And two, most people don't do that. They're not gonna take the time out to do that. So here's the thing, I have done this and I hate it, but I have had to buy different editions. So I had like edition 3 of the workbook, but I had edition 2 of the textbook, and not everything lines up. And oh my goodness, it can get so frustrating sometimes to actually figure out where those pieces should be. And that happened to me once with a teacher's manual. And my teacher's manual did not line up with my readers, my Abeka readers. And it was such a nightmare the entire year. I vowed I would never do that again because we were constantly going back and forth trying to figure out where those pages were. Okay, and five, I have seen this sometimes in the Facebook groups. You can get scammed. There are people that lurk in those groups. They get kicked out when they get found out, but a lot of times it's really hard to get your money back. So they'll say that they're selling such and such curriculum, you'll PayPal them the money, and they disappear. Or they send you a box of things that are not curriculum. So just be aware, those are the things that can happen. The places where I buy used curriculum is eBay, number one. Number two, Facebook buy, sell, swap groups. And number three, used bookstores or homeschool stores. We have a homeschool store in Raleigh and I like to go to that one. That's a great place to go because I can actually look at the books before I actually buy them. So if you are blessed enough to have a homeschool store around you, check it out. All right, so new homeschool curriculum. The pros, obviously everything is brand new and you don't have to worry about anything. Number two, you will have all the current editions, so there's gonna be no frustration with that. Number three, everything is sold together, so you don't have to go hunt down pieces for most of that stuff. If you buy it new, almost everything is going to be on the actual website, and if they're sold out, I'll give you a place where you can go and find it new. Number four, transactions are safer and more secure, so you're not gonna have to worry about getting scammed when you buy it new. Now, the cons, especially if you have multiple kids, the price can get out of hand, or it looks like a lot buying at one time. Now, I have two kids, and I spend around $1,000 to $2,000 a year when we break it all down between curriculum, extra readers, supplies, all of the things that you have to buy to coordinate with it. It can get very expensive. But I am a person who likes to buy new and then sell it at the end of the year. So that's my personal preference because it's just easier for me. And then what I'll do is I will sell my new curriculum at the end of the year, and then I will get the money for that, and I'll use that to fund at least 50% of what I'm going to buy then the following year. And that kind of helps keep us going, and that's worked out really well for us. So where I buy these new curriculums, I buy straight from the company website. Christianbook.com is another place where you can find good deals and things like that. And Christianbook.com a lot of times has sales on different curriculum. And three, homeschool conventions. And if you buy at the convention, I believe you do get a discount for some of those places. So tips for buying new. One, buy during sales season, which is usually in the fall to winter time. Buy at the conventions if you have one near you. Obviously this year most conventions were a no-go, but I think they were doing like some online things. Three, if you have multiple kids, do a family style type of thing where you can actually use the same spine for multiple children. And a lot of curriculums do that, like My Father's World does that. I think The Good and the Beautiful does that. a lot of curriculums do that. Pop it down below if you have one that you know of or that you use that also does that. Help out your friends. And four, save throughout the year. So put a little bit back each month to save up for that larger transaction and for school supplies. One of the great things about homeschooling is we don't have to, you know, buy uniforms or, you know, the stuff to pack the lunches and all the clothes and everything like that. We don't have to worry about that, but we do have to worry about the books and all of the supplies, and there will be things that come up during the year that you're gonna have to buy as well. So I like to kind of put a little bit of money back, and that helps me feel like, okay, I have a little stash going. So when this transaction has to come up and I have to purchase new curriculum, it's not so much of a hit. So those are my tips, guys. If you have any other tips, make sure you pop them down below, and I will put all of these links that I gave you guys in the video in the description box. And if you have any curriculum buying tips, let me know. All right, guys, that's all I have for you today. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.